Hi, I'm John Hassan, executive editor at American Business Media, and I'm here in Springfield, Massachusetts at the Great New England Credit Union Show at the MGM Grand Hotel and Casino. I'm here with Tim Conklin, who's the director of sales for Magner Company out of Middlefield, Connecticut. And I'm interested in talking to you because so many people at this show do things that are, you know, behind the scenes or in the cloud, or they're, whereas your business is machines.
Always
your
has
business
been.
Sitting right there, and this is how it works, and this is why you need it. I mean,
yes.
Because, and actually the great thing about your company too is, regarding credit unions and banks, you guys deal with money, the actual stuff.
Yes.
You know, which is not going away no matter what people try to say, you know?
Well, it's funny you should say that. I started with the company in 1984.
Wow.
It was my first job out of college, and all I heard was that currency and coin is going away.
Yeah.
Everything's going to be on a card.
Yeah.
I figured, boy, I've got to find a new job. This is, well, here we are. Yeah, 2019, there's more coin in circulation. There's more currency in circulation. So people need a way to handle that.
Right. Efficiently and accurately.
Absolutely. Now, the equipment over the years has changed.
Right.
But the idea of what it's used for has not. It's gotten, along with technology, it's gotten more efficient. The price points have come down. But what it's really done for people is it's allowed them, with now the universal type teller, they're teaching their staff to do different things. The equipment is allowing them to do that.
Right. In 1984, when you joined the company, what's the difference between a bill counter then and a bill counter now?
Well, I would say efficiencies,
mm-hmm.
size, and probably the most thing is the cost.
It doesn't cost as much?
Oh, no.
Really?
What we used to sell back in, you know, use the term the day of 1984,
yes.
Was anywhere from $2,800 to $3,500. Well, that same currency processing piece of equipment today is under $1,000.
How many would there be in a decent sized branch?
A coin counter, they're usually going to have one.
What?
Whether it's something that their staff uses behind the scenes,
mm-hmm.
or it's a machine that they put in the lobby
as
for their members
about,
to
right,
use.
Right.
Yes.
And, well, how about bill counters then?
Bill counters, they might have one, they might have two,
okay.
they might have one behind the teller line
yeah.
that, again, their staff uses for daily things, and they might have one in the area where they process and count their ATM money.
Right, right. Oh, okay. And do you sell the ATM machines too?
We do not.
But
we do not.
All the other ways of physically handling money, you guys handle.
Yes. Yeah, so from a basic currency counter to help
right.
verify a strap of money,
mm-hmm.
let's say that came in from their armored carrier,
right.
To a cash recycler
mm-hmm.
that a teller is going to use to process member transactions,
mm-hmm.
both incoming and outgoing.
Right. Do you... Can your coin counter handle those gold dollar coins?
Yes, they can.
Oh.
Interesting fact is when we came out with the several variations
mm-hmm.
of the dollar coin, our machines function by looking at the alloy, the metal content
oh,
or
okay.
makeup. Well, when the mint made all three of those variations,
mm-hmm.
the metal makeup never changed.
Oh. So it didn't cause a problem for
us. It didn't affect our customers having to, you know, have us come in and modify something, and it didn't affect us equipment-wise either.
One of the things that's interesting I've always felt about banking and financial services is that if you sell candy, you miss a few bags of this and that and whatever, you know, or if you sell, you know, if you're at a nails or you're selling hooks at Home Depot, shrinkage, right? You know, whatever.
Right.
But we're talking about money.
There is no shrinkage.
Where is the thing? Where is that?
Right.
So you guys provide like a backbone service to these institutions. I mean, they're as good as you guys are.
Well, and it's twofold. Yes, they balance to the penny.
Yeah.
But also there is a whole chain of command, if you will, that tellers are held to that standard.
Yeah.
That you can't be, I'm a couple dollars off, no one leaves the branch until we all balance.
Yeah.
So using this equipment for the efficiencies of that is in a very, very high regard.
Yeah, and one question I had too is, how do you check machines like yours? How do you make sure they're cooking and doing everything right? Because it's such a precision event that has to be accurate. You can't be close. You have to be right.
Exactly. And the technology is such that the machines now know when they make a mistake.
Or they self-check?
And they tell us or the customer that we need you to go back and look at something. We do ongoing preventive maintenance with our equipment, so our technicians are out there checking, double checking when we do those PMs, the equipment is always running at its utmost efficiency.
Mm. How would you say the business has changed as long as you've been in it? How would you say, how was your job different now than when you started? Or the industry, how is it different?
Well, first off, the industry has shrunk
from
1984 to today. Mergers, acquisitions, things like that. The product mix has changed greatly. Back when I first started, we were selling paper shredders, decalators, bursters, time stamps. Mm-hmm. We were selling check verification equipment. Well, through the years, technology has taken care of a lot of that where those equipment aren't needed. Or simply, we have places like Staples and Office Max that offer some of that equipment. So over the years, we've trimmed down our product line to our base core, which is the handling of coin and currency.
Right. Now, later today, I plan to knock over a bank, and I'm going to take a lot of those bags of cash.
Okay.
I was wondering, you know, because, you know, it's going to be a long weekend, and I need a lot of cash. So
got it.
I'm just going to take it.
Okay.
But that paint, when you open it up, you know, how do I get around that? I assume you know how you know, because I can't say I'm in Blue Man Group and that's cool. You know, I can't. That's not going to work.
Well, there's many stories of my 30 some odd years in the industry that I could tell.
Yeah,
but sworn to secrecy on that.
So it's not Tide Pods. That's not going to help me.
No. That's not going to help you.
Guilty. All right. I won't move. You know. All right. Well, thank you very much, Tim.
Thank you.
Had a good conversation. Thank you. That was fun.
Have a great afternoon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is John Hassan from the executive editor at American Business Media at the Great New England Credit Union Show in Springfield, Mass. I've been talking to Tim Conklin of Magner.